India has launched its first Mars rover in the 41st attempted mission from Earth to the Red Planet. The US, Russia, and the European Union have already completed 18 successful missions there. But with the increasing realization that all of us on this planet are in this thing together, that one nation's scientific discovery in space will, maybe not immediately, but eventually benefit everyone, how is it an efficient use of our precious collective resources to undertake these repetitive, overlapping space missions? Looking at these charts, you see that all of the countries that aren't called the United States have about a combined $21.75 billion yearly space budget. These figures include all of their military space spending as well. On the other hand, the United States' non-military competing space budget alone is almost as much at about $19 billion a year. But there is also a lot of cooperation in space after all. The International Space Station is called that for a reason, with astronauts from 14 different countries having visited at some point. But imagine how much more opportunity for cooperation there could be if those domestic space budgets were combined under one streamlined global agency. This would also be symbolic of the cooperation that needs to happen worldwide in the 21st century if we're going to solve the most pressing issues of our time, like climate change, for example. Of course, I'd be mistaken if I didn't mention that the United States' yearly space budget for military and intelligence gathering is more than $43 billion a year, which is a staggering amount that's more than NASA and the rest of the world's budgets combined. So there are tremendous opportunities to increase space exploration spending by simply shifting national priorities away from war toward peace, but that's a topic for another video. The main question I aim to ask here is, isn't it time to put nationalism and wasteful competition, like India's $72 million mission to Mars, aside and create a system where every nation works together to probe the cosmos for the answers that all Earthlings crave? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Do you think my idea is too pie in the sky, so to speak? Thanks for watching. For the Daily Conversation, I'm Bryce Plank.